This is Dr. Brett Gerber, seen in a 2013 mugshot from the Mono County Sheriff's Department. That's in Northern California, near Yosemite. Gerber was found with ecstasy and psychedelic mushrooms during a traffic stop on his way to the Burning Man Festival. According to documents from the Medical Board of California, Gerber entered into a six-month diversion program that would allow him to keep a clean criminal record. But it did have an impact on his medical career. Gerber was investigated by the State Medical Board and placed on a two-year probation that required him to undergo random drug testing and to stay out of trouble. Carolyn Olstad took her oldest son to Dr. Gerber from 2010 to 2012 before he was caught with the drugs.
I was shocked because he always seemed super buttoned up, you know? So it definitely changed my perception of him.
She says she understands doctors can make mistakes in their personal lives. It's when that behavior crosses into the doctor's office that she has a problem.
If he wants to go out and party and stay out till 2 in the morning, that's totally up to him. If he's doing it and then coming and seeing my baby, then I'm going to have a problem. If he seemed under the influence or anything like that, yes, I would have brought it up.
The drugs incident happened away from his office, but that's not true with the dirty needles. A few years later, a medical assistant reported seeing Dr. Gerber use expired and unauthorized needles from a box that contained dead insects and what appeared to be rodent droppings. According to the assistant, he used them on a 2- and 10-year-old patient. This was in 2016, while Dr. Gerber was working in Hillcrest, according to the documents from the board. In a statement, the Scripps Clinic in Hillcrest said, when it was discovered that he had brought in non-standard needles from home, a full investigation and disciplinary actions were taken, which included removing him from patient care. Scripps also reported the issue to the California Medical Board.
Jurisdiction of the board is on the license of the physician.
Carlos Villatoro is with the State Medical Board. I reached out to him to find out what happens when doctors get in trouble.
Every disciplinary decision that the board makes is tailored around the facts of the case. So there is a no one-size-fits-all answer for discipline.
Villatoro says once a quality of care complaint is made to the board, another physician reviews all the submitted paperwork. If they believe further investigation is needed, the case is forwarded to the Department of Consumer Affairs Health Quality Investigation Unit. Then their sworn peace officers take over. If they find that a doctor has violated the Medical Practice Act, they submit their conclusions to the California Attorney General's office. From there, the accused doctor can enter into a settlement with the Attorney General's office or request a hearing. There are no red lines in the process, nothing a doctor can do that will automatically cause them to lose their license. Villatoro says the Attorney General's office makes a recommendation to the medical board on how a doctor will be professionally punished. Ultimately, the board has the final say.
The board's discipline can be as severe as license revocation. However, it can include probation and a public letter of reprimand. We also have a cite and fine program, which is not considered discipline, in which we issue citations.
If through the course of the investigation, consumer affairs officers believe a doctor has broken criminal law, they would contact the appropriate law enforcement agency to pursue criminal charges. Gerber, now off probation for the prior offense, is being investigated again through the medical board's process. While it's been years since Carolyn Olstad has taken her son to Dr. Gerber, it has made her think a little bit more about how much research she should be doing before she chooses a doctor.
You expect that the medical community would have gotten rid of the doctors that aren't any good, so you can trust that whenever you walk into a hospital that you'll be cared for.
We have lots of tools for consumers to use.
And while the board says it's their top priority to investigate any complaints and discipline doctors who violate the Medical Practices Act, they say there are ways you can look into your doctor too. The board has an app you can download that will notify you if your doctor's medical license has been changed in any way. There's a toll-free number you can call where representatives from the board can answer any questions you have about your doctor's credentials. And you can go onto the medical board's website and search for your doctor to see if any disciplinary action has ever been taken against them by the board. Priya Sridhar, KPBS News.